People nowadays seem to have more problems than ever. They aren't good looking enough. They don't get enough sleep, aren't smart enough, and aren't good enough to manage their time. In a world where there are so many problems, there must be a fix, right? Self-improvement, the pinnacle of selflessness. Self-improvement is the industry that aims to rid you of all of your most profound personal issues and shortcomings. It wants to reveal that you are just a couple of books away from becoming the person you always wanted to be. It sounds too good to be true, because it is. For those of you who have been longtime readers of this blog and YouTube channel, you will know that I'm part of the self-improvement industry. Compared to industries like animal farming, self-improvement may seem like a selfless and harmless thing. Today, I want to reveal the truth. I have meant to write this blog and respective video ever since I started. Why? Because I want to be honest. In many ways, the self-improvement industry is just as corrupt and money-hungry as all the other big businesses like fast food and factory farming. Industries that feed off the ignorance of innocent people want to get the things they want quickly and conveniently. Of course, there are facets of the self-improvement industry that are genuinely good. Today, however, I want to illuminate the problems with the vast majority of the industry. Hopefully, by having these things revealed to you, you will differentiate between the good and the bad. The first thing that we'll need to do is look at how dopamine works in your brain. What is up, YouTube? My name is Aidan Helfant. I'm an upcoming freshman Cornell University student who makes videos on life advice as well as learning and fitness. Before we get further into the video, I just wanted to thank you guys from the bottom of my heart for 50 subscribers. I started this channel because of the whims of my parents and out of self-interest. It has been a great help in allowing me to facilitate the information I read and consume. Ultimately though, this channel is for you guys and gals. It has been for allowing me to show you what I've learned through my life so you might be able to implement it into your own. This channel means so much to me and I can't wait to keep making things better in the future. I don't plan on stopping even if it takes another year just to get to 100 subscribers. Let's get back into the video. Dopamine is the secret weapon of businesses all around the globe. These industries realize that what makes us want to buy a product is dopamine release at some point in its use. They find sneaky little ways to spike our dopamine levels as high as possible. The fast food industry does this by adding vast amounts of chemicals that our brain just doesn't know how to comprehend. Corn syrup, sugar, saturated fats, things that our ancestors found hard to find in nature and therefore taste incredibly good to us nowadays. The problem with this use of dopamine is that it messes with our other areas of life. When we spike our dopamine in this way, doing tasks that release less dopamine is way more difficult. We have all experienced this. Why do you think so many find it so hard to sit down and read a book nowadays? With the onset of social media and movies, reading a white page with black text seems awful in comparison. This is the problem with dopamine. It's supposed to work for us. Our brain wants us to find the things that bring us the most pleasure and make us crave them more. Back in the Neolithic era, sugar and fats would have been a fantastic find to many humans. Nowadays, however, we have an overabundance of these things, but our brains still haven't evolved to realize a difference. Now that we know how dopamine works at influencing our decisions, let's see how this relates to the self-improvement industry. People love self-improvement for the same reason they love every other big industry, dopamine release. Think about it. Why do people consume self-improvement? It's because they believe there is something wrong with them and they want to improve it. They might want better time management skills, so they read a book on productivity. They might want to learn how to finance better, so they read a book on finance. They might want to make a habit of going to the gym, so they research on various health books and literature. Regardless of the reason, people consume self-improvement content to better themselves in some way. This is where the problems arise. When people consume self-improvement content like this, they feel good. They feel really good. This is because the brain releases a vast amount of dopamine. This dopamine is released regardless of if they implement the things they learned or not. The brain can't determine the difference between us implementing the things learned or thinking that we implemented the things we learned. This is where the problem with self-improvement comes. The issue is that many people never actually improve themselves. They think they do. They consume endless amounts of videos, books, and podcasts on how to become the ideal version of themselves, all while doing nothing to make it a reality. You see, our brain doesn't like doing hard things, so consuming self-improvement content is easy. Implementing the things we learn, however, is insanely difficult. The thing that you need to understand is that you're the fix. The self-improvement industry at large may be creating the problem in the first place, but you have the power to stop it. It would be best if you did a couple of things to fix the issue. I'm not gonna lie to you, it will not be easy. That's the whole reason the self-improvement industry works in the first place. It's easier to consume rather than apply. In order to leave the rat race, you have to actually apply what you consume. Easier said than done. So the next time you learn a lesson that you believe will add value to your life, take a couple of days or weeks to actually apply it. What is the point of reading about how to improve your life if you never actually do? This will be very hard. The second thing to do alongside this is to fix your dopamine levels. As discussed before, dopamine can be both a blessing and a curse. It's supposed to point us towards what we should do, but often points us in the wrong direction. To fix our dopamine levels, we have to learn to love doing hard things. There's one analogy that I love towards showing the power behind doing this. Imagine there's a carrot and a cake on a table. The cake looks delicious. It has a nice chocolate glaze with freshly picked strawberries on top, a new topping of whipped cream and caramel frosting. Finally, an interior layer of vanilla with bits of Oreo crumble. The carrot is a carrot. It's orange. Which one would you pick? I don't care what you said, almost all of you would pick the cake, regardless of if you lied to yourself or not. Why is it so hard to pick the carrot? It's because the cake is right next to it. If the cake is absent from the equation, choosing the carrot doesn't seem nearly so bad. This works in the same way with other things in life. When we know that there is a cake next to our carrot, picking the carrot is almost impossible. How do we use this to our advantage? Just slowly remove the cake from the equation. See, our brain doesn't actually know the difference between the carrot and the cake. Only when they are next to each other can we make a choice. The cake is what we want. If you have to choose between looking at memes and reading a nonfiction book, you're gonna choose the memes. If you remove the memes from the equation, the nonfiction book seems much less daunting in comparison. Realize what the self-improvement industry is doing. They do not want you to improve yourself. If they did, they would have no more people to consume their content. They dangle the carrot in front of your face like a donkey, but never allow you to actually eat it. Realize this. Once you take this to heart, you will never be able to consume self-improvement advice passively ever again. At least, not without feeling bad about yourself. So actually apply what you read. Stop consuming so much and implement. Instead of moving from one piece of advice to another, see if the advice you learned was good. Fix your dopamine levels. Learn to do hard things over easy ones. The brain only knows the difference when they're in the same medium. If you want to know a good place to start, look through my other content, but don't do it in one fell swoop. I don't care if I miss out on some viewers if they don't read all of my articles at once. I care that you actually apply what I have to say by giving the information enough time to marinate. Do these two things and you might just be able to become a version of yourself you always wanted to be. All right, guys, that is gonna wrap it on up. I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to check out my other content on the channel, as well as my blogging website, which hosts a plethora of other things as well. Like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. As always, I hope you have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.